I want to greet every one of you that are here today. I know some of the pastors and deacons must have done that, but I still want to go ahead and do that. Before I move forward in the administration, I want you to know if you believe it. If you don't, it's okay. But if you believe it, this is your coming. It's not ordinary. It's not ordinary. There are certain prayers that the Lord made me to pray today in the midnight. And I saw some new people that were hungry for certain things. It doesn't mean hunger of the belly, but probably they've been waiting for things, expectations. You've tried all your power, your brain, everything, but nothing comes. I believe God, it will be with you today. So I want to welcome you. Feel at home. The church, this church is not a local church. We are all over the world. We're in Nigeria, we're in South Africa, we're in North Carolina, we're in Dallas, we're in Canada, we're here in Atlanta. So it is the Lord's doing, it's not anybody doing it. That's the way the Lord is doing. And 2021, we are going to spread out even more. Because the kingdom has to move. If you are here for the first time, this is your first time in this house, we would like you to stand up. Thank you. Thank you, church. I would like to start with the lady. Let's know your name and where you are coming from and who introduced you to the church. Shalanda. Yolanda. Okay, good. You're coming from Baron. Where is that Baron, Georgia? 15. Oh, from Mekin. Okay. Mekin is like 2 hours, right? Okay. Wow. Okay, so you came via Tanika. Come on, let's clap our hands for her. We welcome you in Jesus Christ. I know that you have a reason why you came. We're doing the child education today, and that is the reason why you came, if it is going to be by today. So, blessed are those that you rejoice with others. As you rejoice with her, yes, many other things will come your way. God bless you. Yes, sister. You are who? Kenjula. Can you pronounce? Tenjula. Ten okay. Well, I'm learning all these names now. And you came also on behalf of Tanika. We thank the Lord. Clap your hands for her. We welcome you. Let's go to Willie. Okay, you came by my newfound daughter. Thank you for coming. A young one, can I know you? Tell me your name. What's your name? Wow, that's a long name. Something Witherspoon. Kaylee Witherspoon. Her father's name is Witherspoon. I love that. She did not pronounce her name alone. She joined her father's name. I want you to really know me. So how old are you? You are six. Wow. That's a good six. That's a good six. God bless you, daughter. God bless you. Thank you for coming. Please be seated. We know you. You are part and parcel of us. And we tell you, stand up, daughter. Stand up. You feel good? You're okay? Amen. We thank God for you. We pray for you all the time. Which one of you is related to Tenten? Oh, okay, so this is your... Oh, this is your aunt. And this is your sister. Okay, your cousin. We want to see as a church that we know what happened. We know that your sister, right? The mother was your sister. Okay. Your sister passed in an accident. And her daughter. So we want to say you receive the comfort of God. We prayed for you. After we had the whole thing, we did not just pray for our own person, we also prayed for you. So receive the comfort of God. And don't believe that that is what God brought. No. It's an enemy. And that's why you should use that as a yardstick to know that Satan, you cannot go forth in this family. You've gone and can stop you. If you do that, you will see the glory of God. Our daughter was also there. She was in the accident. And I think she has a broken leg or something. Right? Oh, no. She hurt her leg. Okay. But not the bones were not broken. Look at Jesus. In the same car that killed the grandmother and the grandmother and the mother. But look at God. It's not because she's young. It is the covering of the blood. The Lord shielded her. And she has a purpose on that. And the purpose will be established. Yes, young man. Who? Kareem. Oh, you were invited by Kareem and her mom. God bless you. You have a baritone voice.
I was invited by Kareem.
I like your voice. That's man. So what's your name? Gary. God bless you. And I like your hair. Beautiful. Amen. With the beard. How long have you been keeping the beard? 15 what? When you were 15? How old are you now? That's a good one. Wow. I couldn't keep beards like that. It just get me tired. So I thought I'd pull it away. Thank you for coming today. We appreciate you for coming. Come on, clap your hands for them. So today also, as the service moves forward, my son and Joy, the wife, who happened to be Jason's father and mother, will be dedicating Jason's and Tenika's son. Amen. I know many of you have not, you may not be doing this, but it is essential you do it. It is Christian-like that you should be given a name. They don't give you name before you were born. They give you name, we stamp the name on you after you have been born. And then you are now dedicated. Dedicated to who? To God. So once you are now dedicated to God, God becomes the caretaker of the church. Can we have an amen? So this is what we are going to do for them today. Chinese man, how are you? Why are you crying? You need food? I think he needs some food. So it's a joyful day, isn't it? All right. But I needed to share some things with you to hear what God is saying. The Bible says in the book of Revelation, it says, he that have ears, let him hear. And of course, it's not this ear God is talking about. He's talking about spiritual ear. He said, let him hear what the Spirit says to the church. The Spirit of God is speaking to the church. You will be hearing me speaking, but it is the Spirit that speaks through me. So hear what the Spirit says to you and have a change in your life. I want to thank God for our bishop. Bishop is our sister's sister. Sister Beatrice, they are sisters. I mean blood sisters. And then they are also sisters in Christ. Because both of them are. Bishop is an ordained woman of God. The husband was an apostle. He established a church before he passed to be with the Lord. And she is now giving the church a covering. So she's a great, great woman of God. Come on, let's clap our hands for her. I don't forget, Bishop has a beautiful daughter here. She has two daughters. You know one. Joanne used to visit us here. And now, Joanne is married and has a bouncing baby boy. And another one is on the way. So we thank God for that blessing. Hallelujah. Somebody shout glory. I want you to leave the children today. Let everybody stay in the church today. Amen. Then, but she has another daughter, which is younger than Johan. And she is Andrea. Andrea, stand up. Let us see your beautiful face. Since Andrea came, she has been very serviceable in the Lord, in the house. I am proud of her. She kept herself to serve God. And it is because of how she was brought up. You know, that's to tell you that the fruit of this thing is flowing on her. Train your children the way they should go. Train them the way they should go. She could have gone out now, beautiful girl, looking for men all over the place. Yes. But she won't do that because she knows where she's coming from. The advantage of parents training their children is just beyond something we can measure. Train the children the way they should go. And train them before they become teens. Because after they become that teen, some of them become so cocky. They don't want to listen to you again. But if you catch them young and train them in the way of the Lord, you will enjoy their presence forever. But even as I sound, it's not impossible. The Lord will still touch their lives. Somebody shout hallelujah. I want to speak by the Holy Spirit. Isaiah chapter 22. We stand up for the word of God. I don't have to tell you that all the time. Honor the word. Isaiah chapter 22, verse 22. Thus saith the Lord of hosts, and the key of the house of David will I lay upon his shoulder, so he shall open, and none shall shut, and he shall shut, and none shall open. Somebody say the key of David. Proverbs chapter 3. Proverbs chapter number 3. And let's look at verse 4. Now, we'd like every one of us to speak this into existence. Proverbs 3, 4. 1, 2, go. You see, as a child of God, you are to be finding not hatred, closing doors on you. It should be favor. There is something that make it happen. What might happen is the anointing for success. And by the grace of God, I will release that anointing upon you today. Do you know my name? What's my name? You think I just got it from the dustbin? No. God gave me that name. Amen. He gave it to me by anointing. So you move with me, you are under my covering, you should be successful. And you will have favor everywhere you go. I decree upon your life, no more failures. In Jesus' name. Holy Spirit of God, we thank you. We acknowledge your presence. Thank you for your presence. Thank you for bringing us out here today. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, I say, let favor be our portion. Let the key of David open impossible doors. Doors that are impossible. There are places we never dreamt of that we should be able to penetrate. But with this anointing today, take us far and beyond. In Jesus' name I pray. Somebody be seated. I want to speak on the key of the house of David opened the doors of favor. The key of the house of David opened the door of favor. As you begin to receive this grace and anointing, the Lord will use it to take you through, especially this month of October. In the name of Jesus. My beloved, how do we enter into God's presence? I know the Bible says we enter his presence with thanksgiving, with praises. But before thanksgiving, what are you thanking God for? Why do you have to thank God as you are approaching his holy of holies? Our God is a holy God. And almost all men, women, have come short of that holiness. So the Lord gave us a solution. And the solution is the blood. So we cannot approach God except by blood only. God is a spirit. And anyone that have to come to him and worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. The truth today, there is favor when you approach God by the blood. God is not a human being. He doesn't have a physical body. God is a spirit. So for you to go to him and approach him, you got to go by blood. If I have a better amen to that, in the book of Hebrews, chapter 10, verse 19, the Bible says, enter into the holiest by the blood of Jesus. Maybe this will make you, if you understand what I'm teaching you or what I'm preaching to you, this will make you to really honor Jesus Christ as truly your Lord and your Savior. You cannot approach God without the blood of Jesus. That is why many of us, our prayers are not answered, because we lack the knowledge of approach. President Trump, how many of you here have the access to just walk into President Trump's office? An ordinary human being. It is because many times we are not rating God the way he operated. We sometimes think God is daddy. God Almighty is not your daddy. God Almighty is not your playmate. He is the creator. That body you carry was created by God. The sea was created by God. The wind was created by God Almighty. The Bible says in the beginning, darkness covered the earth. But God began the creation because he got the power to create. Every food you are eating today, he spoke them into existence. We need to honor God and give him the true glory that he deserves. Every bird that fly in the air, they give God glory. They sing to God. The fish in the sea, they swim, and I believe they glorify God because they are found in their habitat. What happened to the animals in the kingdom, in the wilderness? They glorify God Almighty that created. The only people, the only creators, or rather creatures, that don't give God true glory. We feel too cocky. We feel too big. Sometimes because of our educational background.
This woman has a PhD. I have double PhD. But my PhD means nothing. I got a God that I got to have. I got a God that I got to present a glory to. Rise up and give God his glory. He can shut down your educational progress in a minute. Don't let pride be your portion. When you humble yourself, beloved, you go with the blood of Jesus. All the angels are fascinated at your presence. Angels. They will be saying, oh, she's coming. And then they will be somewhere. Who is she? Do you know her? She's one of the two. He's one of the sons of God. But when many of us, sometimes the way we give offering here, let me tell you, this is not my culture. It doesn't mean African culture, because sometimes when I preach, you think it's Nigerian culture. If it is Nigerian culture is a good culture. Learn what is good in it and throw the bad ones out. When you are giving offering, don't bring your offering with the left hand. It is a spiritual culture. Left hand is regarded as sacred. Do you remember when Jacob was to bless the sons of Joseph? He looked at Manasseh and his brother, and he crossed his hand. And then Joseph came and said, no, 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 this one is the senior. Don't place the left hand. He said, leave me, I know what I'm doing. And that was how the blessing came upon their lives. Be watchful, beloved, in the spirit world. Once you become a child of God, there is a change in your life. Ignorance is not an excuse. That is why you are being taught every day the efficacy of the movement of the spirit world. You have to understand how to operate. The operation of the spirit is what blesses us or it shuts you down. Hallelujah. But if you do it right, you get the blessings. And you will enjoy the favor. How do you do it right? You cannot do anything right except my blood. Open your mouth now and say, thank you for the blood. Say, Lord, thank you for the blood. So, beloved, it takes the blood. And I want you to understand that it is the first, the outpouring of the blood. Check it from the book from Genesis. If you keep checking relationships of man with God Almighty, it is always the outpouring of blood first before the outpouring of the Spirit. You cannot have the outpouring of the Spirit. You cannot be anointed until the blood has been shed. And until you believe in the efficacy of that blood. The blood has to be applied to your life. This is what makes you righteous. You are not righteous because you did not have sex with somebody. You are not righteous because you fasted. No. You are righteous because God sees the blood. Let him see the blood on you. Let him see the blood of the Lamb of God on you. In fact, in the Holy of Holies, there is a chair. This is called the Ark of the Covenant. And this Ark of the Covenant, that is where the mercy seat is. Amen? The mercy seat of God, where God sits and takes decisions over lives, over nations. There is a seat that is over this place. What is it that God is sitting on? There are three things that judge you. That's not my message today. Amen. God took those three things and put it inside the ark. Are you listening to me? And then the place is seat on the blood of Jesus to remind God all the time that the blood was shed for this person that come to God.
That is why God will not refuse nor reject you when you cry to him. It is because of blood. So God is sitting on that blood. The mercy seat that is placed there. And God will sit upon that blood. And the blood is his speaking blood. The blood cried all the time on your behalf. He cried for your mercy. He cried for your grace. He cried for your help. He said, Lord, will this person need help? And so the Father cannot deny you. I mean, cannot. I didn't say he will not. He cannot deny you because of the blood. That is why you see that the world now don't preach about the blood. Because there is a spirit of the Antichrist. Everything they are coming against is actually what makes them spiritual. What will make their relationship with God to be cordial. You need a cordial relationship with God Almighty. You were made by him, for him, and in him. And so your relationship with him has to be cordial. The just shall live by faith. Your faith in the blood will make it. Even if the enemy plans something, the blood can change the plans of the enemy. So today, I prophesy on everyone that can listen and receive this prophecy, that in the name of Jesus Christ, every influx of the enemy, the blood cut it off today. The blood cut off the works of the devil. It is on you, you shall die. You shall lead to declare the works of the Lord in the land of the living. Somebody shout a better amen. Now, after the blood has been poured on the cross, we saw that the Lord Jesus Christ rose from the dead, and when he now ascended to the Father, 40 days, that was when the Holy Spirit was poured upon mankind. And that is favor. He opened the door of favor for us to have the Holy Spirit. It is the blood. The blood of Jesus is the blood of favor. Apply to everything that has to do with you. Your job, your business, your life. Apply the blood. And favor will be your portion. Somebody help me shout amen. Now, after the Spirit has come, we have to now understand how what and what pleases the Spirit of God. The Spirit of God is not a power. As many have taught, the Spirit of God is God. And he should not be treated with as if he's nobody. He is God. In fact, the book of Job, chapter 30, I believe, says this: it is the Spirit of God that made you, and the breath of the Almighty has given you life. So this body that is speaking today, the stars, the everything you see that is in existence, it is the Spirit that made them. Respect the Holy Spirit. Let your relationship with the Holy Spirit be very cordial. We are in his dispensation. We are in the dispensation of the Spirit of God. And because we are in the dispensation of the Spirit of God, walk with the Spirit. Hallelujah. Glory be to God, the Lord Jesus Christ, who is our Savior, has mapped out everything for us. He is the one that have that key. But I want to tell you today, what is God saying in Isaiah 22, verse 22? The Holy Spirit is saying to us this morning that there is a prophetic authority of Christ. So he's speaking about the prophetic authority of Christ. That Isaiah 22, verse 22, that speaks about the key of the house of David, is a prophetic authority. Hallelujah. Now, that prophetic authority, according to the scripture, what does it do? It opens doors and it closes doors. Is somebody listening to me? That prophetic authority opens doors and closes doors. You want your door to be open all your life. In fact, God gave us a word in the book of Isaiah. Isaiah chapter 60, verse 11. It says, your gates shall continually be open day and night. It shall not be closed. That the Gentiles, the word Gentiles mean nations, should bring the wealth of Gentiles to you. God loves you so much, beloved. But many of us rely too much on our power, abilities. We got to drop our abilities and take and begin to focus by faith on the ability of God to do things for us. If your doors are not open day and night, the wealth that God expects you to have, you won't have it. Wealth is not money. Wealth is a whole bunch of goodies that come to you. Landed properties, all this, you are not supposed to be struggling and be paying mortgage. Maybe you don't know English. Check the word mortgage and see what it is. I don't have to define it to you. The word mortgage means cemetery. Cemetery. That is why you bought a home for $300,000. And most of the time, not you in Jesus' name, they don't pay it until they die off. The children will come and be taking over the debts. This ought not to be for a child of God. Why do you have to flow inside the wrong system? Ask yourself a very beautiful question. Must I flow in the system? Let me tell you what I mean by this system. It's called Babylonian system. Babylonian system is slavery. Babylonian system is a system where you work for people and they sit down and eat it. And many children of God have caught up in it all over the world. All over the world. It's not only America. You find it, you find the system in Europe. This is what God we should come against. We are actually supposed to come against the Babylonian system. The wealth. How people struggle for wealth. Only 1% in America here, if you don't know, let me tell you. I was not born here, but I know a lot about the system. In America here, only 1% of the entire population get the money. You don't get any money. Is it that $2,000 you are struggling for every month? No money. Somebody said that's no money. I mean, and that's what God has for you. Apostle Bala can prove it to me. Yes. I can prove it to you scripturally. Who owns the earth? In Psalm 24, which is to be fulfilled now. We are moving in the realm of Psalm 24. It says, the earth is the Lord's. And who is thereof? Who's that fellow in? He said, because your God, your Father, founded it upon the seas and established it upon the floods. He said, who then shall come to the hill of the Lord? Who is he that has the faith what God has? It's only those that have clean hands and a pure heart who has not lifted their soul unto vanity. Which means you got to surrender your spirit to God. It's your spirit, it's not your body. In Africa, we have a tribe. Yoruba, that is actually Kunle's tribe. In Nigeria. When they want to greet the elders, they bow down. Good morning, sir. It's a fine culture, but it is bodily greeting. I can respect, I want to show respect to a bishop now, as a mother, as a bishop, as everything, and I come and say, oh, good morning, man. I bow down with my body, but my spirit may not bow down. I don't know if you're catching me. In America, you don't bow down. Even to your mother, you don't do it. But it's wrong. very wrong. When you have a mother or you have a father, learn to respect them. The Bible says, honor your father and your mother so that it may be well with you. That's why many have problems. You cross your mother, you cross your father, you jump door on them. This ought not to be for a child of God. That's number one. That's how to start. Respect the woman that gave birth to you. Respect the father that supplied the seed. Can I have an amen? This is what will make the Babylonian system to be destroyed. Because God will now begin to release his glory upon you. You have honored your mother. You have honored your father. So the system that you are in is called godly system. And then you begin to go like that. I was talking to the young man today. I said, Emile, we alighted from the car. I want you to pick the basket. But, you know, being that he was not taught, he expected my son to pick it up. He said, oh, he's here. He will pick it up. I said, you are wrong. That man is 50 plus. I said, you are only 13. And one day you will be 50 plus too. So you need to do good to respect the one who has been above you. So to God be the glory. Immediately we landed, he picked it up. He picked it up. And these are things that the school will not teach you. We are so many useless teachers these days. Yes. I am a trained teacher. I have a grade 1 certificate. We have grade 2, grade 1. Certificate to teach. Amen. When I'm teaching, I don't just teach mathematics. I teach life to those children. Almost all the children I taught in school, many of them are in top positions today. Said that they are in the custom, they are somewhere, big people. And then one day I was coming, I just came back from, I just entered Nigeria. And my passport, I took up my passport. And somebody cited me, just like my friend here with beards. His own beard was even too much, big, and he's a huge person. He just came up frustrated for me. I said, who are you? He says, sir, you don't know me again. You were my mathematics teacher. You taught me mathematics. But more so, you did not teach me mathematics alone. You taught me life. That's the kind of teachers that we are expecting. Not mago teachers. Teachers that are just after salary. We have nurses too that are not nurses. Nurses that have no compassion. They no compassion at all. They just want to put their money. Go. They constitute themselves into killing men. We have policemen who are not police. They are political judges. People sent to murder another nation, another tribe. That's the system I'm talking about. It is an injustice, a system of injustice, a system of evil. It is Babylonian. A person cannot be running from a police. I spent 8 years carrying gun. You are wrong for shooting somebody in the back. An innocent person that have no gun, you just shoot him in the back. What is that? I pray that the young men in America, this time I'm not talking politics and I'm not talking race, but I'm saying to you, these things are spiritual. These things are evil that the enemy perpetrated against the young ones. We have to rise and cover the children on the land of God so that they can grow and have a future. So this is it, brothers. You need to wake up. System is wrong. It is Babylonian. The same thing about the finances. They take it. Some of our young ones now that are in the university, they have no future. Yes, they went to school. Some of them in Yale. Some of them very big, big universities. But as they come out, the certificate means nothing. Except the Lord delivers. Except the Lord saves. The aid that built in the houses amount to nothing.
It's only the Lord. It's only the hand of the Lord. That is why we should bring the children to the Lord. As this young boy is being brought to the Lord today, the Lord receive him, we will dedicate him, and the Lord give him a shield, and the Lord give him a covering, so that his future can be better. It can be better. Somebody help me turn the hallelujah.
So beloved, it's a system. You are not supposed to be in the system. You are not supposed to be in the system. You look at in the church here, just this community of ours. There are some leaders, some elders in the church. There were some of these children doing wrong things. They just turn their face. I see you. It's just that sometimes I don't want to confront you. But I pray for you. I pray for you. Because you don't know where you are. If you are a deaconess, act like one. As a pastor, act like one. Let the spirit enter you. As a prophetess, act like one for the sake of Christ. Things are degenerating. How can Jesus be Lord? We allow things to degenerate. Can I have an amen? The key of David that we have, beloved, I will tell you something that happened in the scriptures. Hallelujah. Immediately the bishop came. She came to me and sat down there and said, Apostle, we have to change something about my daughter. I said, I agree with you. That's a mother. You don't have to tell her. That's a mother. By the grace of God, I will wed and drink very soon. Yes. Somebody say, wed. And let me see anybody who's against it. But I give God the glory. If everybody sees things from that angle, that we have, there should be some decorum. You begin to see that things will work well. I'm not saying you are not trying. Some of us try. But God did not say you should try. He said, be a parent. Parenting is spiritual. I'm telling you, parenting is pure spiritual. Hallelujah. So I want to tell you the story of a man that I love so much in the Bible. His name is Mordecai. Some call him prophet, some look at him and just call him whatever they like. But Mordecai was a man of God. He was taken from their place as a slave. And when they got to the place where they got to, they were flowing in the Babylonian system. Mordecai was given to be a gate man. Gate man. He watches the gate, he opens and closes and salutes whoever is coming. But there was something in the inside. And God was with him. He had a daughter, just like this young beautiful girl. Not his biological daughter. But he raised her. Name is Esther. I want you to understand these two have their relationship. Esther was a young girl being trained by Mordecai. Mordecai, as a gate man, had a formidable enemy. In spite of the fact that he was a gate man, the enemy was still attacking taken his life. That is why I tell you, beloved, there is war over everything. You want to marry? There is war over that marriage. You start a business, little business, growing. There is war. The gather. Because whatever a child of God does is blessed. So it is that blessing that is making them to war against you. How much more those of us that are called into ministry. Who Mordecai's enemy? His name is Haman. Haman wanted to extinct the entire race of the Jews. They should not leave. Why? Why should the Jews be attacked everywhere? You ask questions, please. Some of you don't like the Jews. I beseech you today to begin like the Jews. 2 million Jews died in the last chamber before the Second World War. But they could not finish that race because God is with them. Look at them all over the world now. They started as a nation of only 7 million. They were not up to our Georgia, state of Georgia. In the year 1947, brought them together as a nation. And Iran, China, and some other nations like that, they gather up. They want to destroy God's people. The same story that I'm telling you today, this enmity has been on. Do you think, church, do you think you as a Christian, do you think you can escape it? You are under enemy too. The enemy hates you. The system of this world hates you. That is why there should be no compromise. Don't do things the way they do it. Our children go to the same school the way they go. Our children face the same teacher. But beloved, we have to understand that there is a distinction. The blood has brought us under that distinction. Train the children well. Some of you, some of these children are 8 and you leave them like that. Some of them are already sexually active at 8. Because the mother is sleeping. In those days, mothers don't do that. Even we that are boys, at the age of 12, you can't have a girlfriend. Yes! As a boy, I could not have a girlfriend at 12, 13, 14. In fact, we do it secretly. You can't. Mother will slap you. What is girlfriend? Oh, yes! Her hand will be on your cheek. Go call up your police. She will slap you again with your police. So part of what made us like this today is because of that discipline. Yes. Not that we carry iPads. At the age of 8, you have iPad. You have phone at the age of 8. Then what do you think the child is going to look at? Pornography. That's what they will be looking at. We expose them to it. If we have the key, we need to use the key. I don't have a biological child. But every children God placed in my life, I watch them like eagles. And no child will be destroyed in my presence. That is the commission of God in my life. I call you to follow suit. Let's get so serious with the children. It's not taking them to one corner and just give them some Bible verses. They cram it. It's called root memory. You can cram Bible. But does your character prove you are a child of God? No character. Somebody shout hallelujah. So this hammer, as I was saying, became the enemy of this. But I want to say something to you. Everybody help me say 24. Say it now. Use it like my mouth. Say 24. I like you to use my own accent. Amen, church. Everybody help me say 24. I want to say to you, and it's coming to you directly, that is a 24-hour miracle.
Can I prophesy in the name of Jesus? A call from heaven, your 24-hour miracles. I say, come out.
This man was at the gate. Mordecai was at the gate. Haman was planning because he was in authority. He was a prime minister and he wanted to extend the Jews. He wants to dismantle them. But his target was Haman. It was Mordecai. If he can destroy Mordecai, if he can take Mordecai out, then every Jew shall be destroyed. But the devil is a liar. We have a God who sits in heaven. He chose you. No man destroy you. You are a chosen generation. You are a new creation. You have been translated. Somebody shout power. Hallelujah. So it is the key of David that opened the door of favor for Mordecai and shut the door of Haman. Look at the way Jesus walked. He just sat down in the heaven looking at them. And I believe he just carried the key and said, look, as I use this key, you angel, go to action. He said, I want you to, that man called Mordecai. Do you know he knows our names? He knows your name. He knows you are Helen. He knows your name. He knows Tetica. He knows Bishop. He knows Helena. He knows you. Enemy. Everyone that is enemy plotting against you that you don't know. You wake up in the morning, you don't know you have an enemy. Somebody is against you. Somebody is against you. But he knows. Somebody said, God knows. You know what he did? He just called the angel. He said, key. Shh. I shut that door. He was a prime minister, but I shut his door. That man called Gate Man. I open his door. Can I prophesy in the name of Jesus? I saw the hand of God be stretched, and I saw the key of the kingdom of God, the key of David in the hand of God concerning you. God will shut down the door of your enemy, and your door shall be open in this month of October. I say your door shall be open because of the blood. Because of the blood, the doors be open. That project shall succeed. That this disaster shall come to pass in the name of Jesus Christ. So look for me quickly in the book of Esther. Look at the book of Esther chapter 7. Look at verse 3. Esther 7 verse 3. Are you enjoying Jesus? I love what they are not. The Esther, the queen, answered and said, if I have found what? If I have found favor, she was talking to the king now. He said, oh king, if I have found favor before you, I'm not just trying to be selfish. It's not about me in the world, but as a family. Are my family. The whole people are my family. That is why we come from a family. In Apostolic Triumphant Church International, you cannot hate one another. We are family in Christ Jesus. Yes, ma'am. He said, O king, and if it please the king, let my life be given me at my petition and my people, my request. She was so interceding for her people. He said, no, my people will not die. I have acted, God has given me favor to the king. If you have favor before the king, my brother, my sister, fight for your people. Fight for your people. Fight for the black race. Fight for the Christian. Fight for the church. Somebody shall fire. Let it go into your spirit. Yes, verse 4, please. He said, look at, very emotional. He said, oh king, don't you know we have been sold? When I sit down on the altar, I'm telling you, the enemy wants to sell the black race. The enemy wants to sell Christians. Are you a Christian? Want to sell it? Yeah. Even you that come from Montgomery. They want to sell you.
Just because you're a Christian.
Are you listening to the word of God? This woman says, we have been sold. I and my people to be destroyed. Number one, they sold them. What is the reason to destroy them? He said to be slain and to perish. But if we have been sold for bond men and bond women, I have held my tongue, although the enemy could not countervail the king's damage. He said, king, if you stand up now, if I have favored you, I want you to please stand up. If you command, the damage will come to the enemy and not on my people.
Come and say, Jesus, judge my enemy. Yes.
That's what Jesus is doing. Let me tell you the truth. What I saw that is moving in the spirit. Judgment is upon this world. And you are not this world. So get it.
You are a child of God. You are not this world. You are a Christian. So judgment is for the world. You are not part of it.
You are a solution. You are what?
A solution.
So as a lady, as Esther spoke to the king, look at what happened. Somebody shout glory. The Lord says, I should say what to you now. He says, I should tell you that you will see your enemy hang on the trap. Every instrument of trap. I wish you are very spiritual.
Say every instrument of trap that they use for you, it says it will go back to the enemy. Somebody say back to sender.
I'm speaking right now. They wanted to kill you. They wanted to kill your son. They wanted to kill your family. They wanted to destroy your business. But I come to let you know when the plan of the enemy shall go back to sender. Somebody shall fire. So, beloved, hear the word of the Lord. It was the key of David that brought the favor upon Mordecai and the Jews. When that favor came on them from the Lord, the king had no option. See, when people refuse you before, and they say, oh, we're not going to do, hey, this is not, and the Lord just raised you. The person may be a family. The person may be at work. The person may be anywhere. But when they refuse you, what is due to you? And you pray and ask God for his favor. And that king opened the door for you. The same will come back. I am so sorry. I thought it like this. Now I am saying, can I have a name in this house? It's coming. That enemy is coming. He's coming to you to come and reconcile with you. He's coming to you to come and tell you, I am so sorry. I had so much about you, and that was what poisoned my mind. But now, I don't know what happened. My mind is clear. Somebody shout glory. Glory be to God. So in Esther 7, come on children, in Esther 7, look at verse 10. Esther 7, verse 10. Look at what the king said. The king just gave that order. The order changed. The king now said,
He said they hung Haman on the gallows that he had prepared for Mordecai.
Gallows prepared for Mordecai, a gate man. How did we transfer it to a prime minister?
I will give names for you. Egypt and Ethiopia. I said, for a ransom, thus saith the Lord. I said, God, we give people for the Lord in the name of Jesus. What is meant for you will be transferred to the enemy.
Do you know that it was when they now hung Haman that the king was now pacified?
Can I prophesy? By the blood of the Lamb, God will not rest. The angels will not rest. I say now heaven will not rest until your enemies are destroyed, until your enemies are terminated. Those that are holding your glory, those that are holding what is yours, as a fire. You must have what God said. The angels will not rest. The cattle booth is a movement time. It's a time of movement. The angelic movement. They will move and they will dismantle. Who are those that are trying to stop you? The trap that they set in the name of Jesus Christ. This trap could be a trap of sickness. It could be the trap of disease. It could be the trap of financial bondage. It could be the trap of death. It could be all kinds of trap. They lock down your marital life. They say you will not enjoy it. They say you will not enjoy even your ministry unto God. But here come God, the God of judgment. I said today is the day God will not rest. The angels will not rest until your enemies are dismantled. Hallelujah. This is the reason why you are chosen, and you got to know you are chosen, and you got to accept that you are chosen. It is the Father that chose you because of the blood of the covenant. He chose you because of the blood. He sees what Jesus did for you, and he chose you. A chosen generation. They cannot stop you. The favor of God has made you unstoppable. You are unstoppable. I say you are on a movement. The exodus of the people, you are on a movement right now. I see you moving. You are moving on the high terrain. I say you are climbing the mountain in the name of Jesus. You shall subdue the mountain in the name of Jesus. I said they shall raise the flag that you have made it.
Beloved, glory to God. Amen.
Mordecai moved from a gate man and was made the prime minister. Se intakapoli Jesus, ite grati kakandole kreti se katanga obateni nisoro uyidi yidi bakwajo kuda basu kuda naye. Rima kuntelia basoku, e potriba bakaria bakasa. You will eat the fruit of your labor, everything you labor for. No man destroy your labor. You will eat the fruit of your labor in the name of Jesus. Your mother, I speak to you. I say in the name of Jesus, you will enjoy the fruit of your children. Nobody will take your children from you. Your children are coming back home.
You say your sons and your daughters shall be carried from afar.
It shall be carried. And those of you that have not had any child, I have a word from the Lord now. In the book of Isaiah, God said, you woman that have no child, he said, watch out. You should expand your coast. He said, because the children are coming. I said, the children are coming. I said, you are fruitful. Even at the age of 100, you are fruitful. I said, you are fruitful. Somebody shall fruit. The battle is over in the name of Jesus. In Psalm 75, verse 6, the word of the Lord says, promotion cometh neither from the east, nor from the west, nor from the south. It cometh from the Father who is above. And I come to tell you now, the Father has stretched his hand of promotion and elevation on you now. It is you are the one now, because of the blood. Covering, because of the blood of the Lamb, you shall be elevated. Promotion is coming from God. Receive your promotion now. Receive your divine elevation in the name of Jesus. The devil cannot stop it again. In 1 Samuel chapter 2, verse 8, this is a woman that was condemned, that they thought she would never pay. A woman that was not God. Her sister was making it, but she was not making it. She was so troubled and cold. She was full of sorrow. But the testimony of the Lord came. He said she began to see the glory of God. And in the day of her testimony, she said, there is a God who raised the poor out of the dunghill. Oh my God. I feel emotional in my spirit. I am very emotional in my spirit. My soul is full of emotion, because there is a God who sits with you. This God is inside you. As if from John 4:4 says, greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. And the Bible says, he made the poor to come out of the dust and lifted up the beggar from the dunghill to set them among the priests. God is setting you among the ruler. You shall come back to rule. You shall be the one on top. And you make it down to inherit the throne of glory. For the pillars of the earth are full of the Lord. The pillars of the earth are full of the Lord. I say to you, yours is coming now. Yours is coming now. Nobody can stop it. Let the fire come. The glory come. Let the anointing come. Somebody say, come down. The days of denial are over. The days of those denial are over. The blood has canceled the day of denial. They have denied you for too long, but the blood has set in now. The angels of God has set in now. So your days of denial are over. They thought you would not get it, but God said, this is your time. The set time is here. My beloved friends, I round up my message. Hallelujah. I round up my message today, and my message is that the favor of God upon your life can silence the enemy's life within a short time. The favor of God is working. Activate that favor with the words of your mouth. Speak favor against sickness. Speak that you are favored. There will be silence. As Haman was silenced, so shall there be silence. I am telling you in the name of Jesus, sickness is no longer going to be in your bodies, because Holy Ghost is at work. All those that you ought to be, what you ought to get. I say, the blood, the efficacy of the blood of the Lamb of God and the anointing of the Holy Spirit will never rest until you get it. Somebody say, until I get it. Jacob had to rest. He rests with God. You are not going until you bless me.
And God began to look at him. He said, can you leave me? Let me go. He said, for where you are not going, you have what I want, and I must get it today. He said, today is the day. And the Bible said, the angel touched the hole of his car, and Jacob began to move like this. He began to walk like that. Until he got to the place he was going. But he got the blessing. He got the blessing. You can remove his tie all you want, but he got to get the blessing. You can pick something from his body, but he need the blessing. I need the blessing in my life. I need the favor of God to open the door for me. I am greater than what I'm seeing. I am higher than what I'm seeing. I got to go higher. I shall not die. You shall not die.